exams coming closer and closer and closer. Some of you may be getting very tensed up. Some of you may be saying, it's okay, yaar, I'll deal with it. But in either case, you'll be having a lot of people who will be telling you, study hard, study hard, study more. Actually, I don't believe in that, you know. I don't think studying hard gets you results. I think studying smart gets you results. What do you mean by this thing called study smart? It means being able to know when to study. There are times when you need to study, there are times when you don't need to study. It means to know where to study. Oh my God, it makes so much difference where and how you're studying, you know that. And then comes the techniques. How to study. There are different ways of studying. What suits you should be the one that you should pick up. Once you do that, then you become selective. What to study, when. After you have mastered this, or while you are mastering it, there will be one question that you need to ask yourself, that is, why to study? Why study at all? Is it just to get that stupid extra marks? No, it's much more than that. So what we are going to do is, we are going to take you through this process of when to study, where to study, how to study, what to study, and why to study. If you understand these concepts, believe me, you'll not only do much better in your exams, you'll have true learning taking place. What goes in will remain permanently with you. Okay? Best of luck. Hi. Today I want to talk about something which very, very few people give importance to, you know. Where do you study? You must study in a room which is quiet, which is cool, which is comfortable, and which is noiseless. As far as possible, study in one place. So that, you know, when you come to that place or that desk, you know that, now it's time for me to study. Don't use the same desk for anything else. Don't use it for dinner or snacking or playing games or whatever it is. Let that place have an aura as though this is where I study, that sort of thing. Keep the table free. You have a clutter of things lying around, then what happens? Your eyes starts going on to that. So make sure there's nothing around which is going to disturb you. Maybe a glass of water, a scribbling pad, a writing pad, and a pen so that the moment you find something important, you can write those sort of things. Okay? Now you've got your place of study. Check out the lighting. Light should come from above and from the left side. Because the right side you keep using to write down and things like that, no? So let the light come from the, you see, from this side if the light comes, this is brightened. Let there not be a glare. If there's a glare coming onto the student from the front, then the eyes start getting tensed up. Your stress level goes up. Now look at your sitting position. Your chair should be firm, straight, straight back, so that the back is supported but it's not too relaxed. Your feet should be firmly touching the ground. If it's a very hard surface, have a thin cushion or something of that sort on your chair. Never face a door or a window where you have activity going on, people passing by and those sort of things. Remember sights. You see something, you get distracted. Sounds. People in the next room are talking. The TV is on and some dialogues or music is going on the TV. Smells. Your mom is cooking something nice in the kitchen and that aroma is coming to you. Avoid all these things. Look at the angle of your book. Preferably see if the book can be propped up like this, so you get a clearer view. A minimum of 18 inches, preferably 2 to 2.5 feet. Now you sit down to study. Once in a while, get up and stretch out. Just stretch your whole body, come back and sit down. Once in a while, make sure you take a break. relax and get going. That's where you study.